Good morning to all. Today we are going to discuss the topic linear independence of vectors. First definition: if v1, v2, etc., vn are vectors, then the expression lambda1 v1 plus lambda2 v2 plus etc. plus lambda n vn, where lambda1, lambda2, etc., lambda n are scalars, is called linear combination of these vectors. Second definition: a set of vectors v1, v2, etc., vn is said to be linearly dependent if there exist scalars lambda1, lambda2, etc., lambda n. Not all zero, such that lambda1 v1 plus lambda2 v2 plus etc. plus lambda n vn equal to zero. Now the third definition: a set of vectors v1, v2, etc., vn is said to be linearly independent if lambda1 v1 plus lambda2 v2 plus etc. plus lambda n vn equals 0. That implies lambda1 equal to lambda2 equal to etc. lambda n equal to 0. Okay. Next, determining linear independence using matrices. Determining linear independence using matrices. Let us consider this: v1, v2, etc., vn be the n vectors. We are finding the linear independence of vectors. We can use the following steps. First step: form a matrix with these vectors as raw vectors. And second step: find the rank of this matrix. Third step: if the rank R is equal to number of vectors, then these vectors are linearly independent, otherwise it is linearly dependent. The problem: are the vectors 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, 5, 3, 4, 5, 6, 4, 5, 6, 7 linearly independent or not? Are the vectors 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, 5, 3, 4, 5, 6, 4, 5, 6, 7 are linearly independent or not? See, first of all, we can consider these vectors as of vectors. See, let us take the v1 is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, v2 is equal to 2, 3, 4, 5, v3 equal to 3, 4, 5, 6, v4 is equal to 4, 5, 6, 7. Now, we can form a matrix using these vectors. That is, that A is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, 5, 3, 4, 5, 6, 4, 5, 6, 7. Now, to find the rank of the matrix by using echelon form, or you can reduce this matrix into upper triangular form. See, we can consider, we can check whether the first row, first element is non-zero or not. See, here in this case, the first row or first element is non-zero element. Make the other elements in that column are zero. Make other elements in that column as zero. That is, you can use R2 gives R2 minus 2 R1, R3 gives R3 minus 3 R1, R4 gives R4 minus 4 R1. That is equivalent to what you get? 1, 2, 3, 4, 0, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, 0, minus 2, minus 4, minus 6, 0, minus 3, minus 6, minus 9. Now what is the next step? Check whether is the second row, second element is non-zero or not. If it is 0, then we can take the other element. Here in this case, second row, second element is known as, that is minus 1. Make the other element in that column lie below the second row, second element as 0. That is, you can write R3 gives R3 minus, the operation is R3 gives R3 minus 2 R2, R4 gives R4 minus 3 R2, that is equivalent to 1, 2, 3, 4, 0 minus 1 minus 2 minus 3, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. See, now we consider the second row, third row. We consider the third row, third element is 0 or not. See, the third row and fourth row are all in the 0. Stop here. Now we can identify how many number of non-zero rows. Here in this case, the number of non-zero rows is 2. That is, rank of A is equal to 2. Number of vectors, N is equal to 4. That is, R is less than n. That means the vectors are linearly dependent. These vectors v1, v2, v3, v4 are linearly dependent.